Kitty Quatch. Okay, aren't those sweet smiles? I'm telling you, the pride. Alexander Minich. Gabe Sizon. Victoria Huang. Isaac Matthews. Isabella Godinez. Hannah O'Keary. Jenna Bigelow. Amy Doe. Amelia Wang. Samantha Williams. I think she's whispering some sweet thoughts to them, can you tell? Amelia Garibaldi. LG Jacqueline. Roberto Garcia. And Karina Sandu. These are amazing students.
Every year, this is the biggest show that I've ever written, and it's true. Part of it is because I love to challenge your amazing children. And I also, over the years, have accumulated so much wonderful music that I want to share with you all. I can tell you this honestly, I am certainly not connected to every music teacher that there is, but I would find it very, very surprising if there was any other group of children in America that is doing what your children do tonight. There's three ways of performing music. You can perform a cappella with no accompaniment or with a soundtrack, and you'll hear that at the end of our program. But the third way to perform is what we call acoustically, where someone is accompanying you or you're accompanying yourself. And there are so many numbers this evening where your children are accompanying themselves, which is very difficult to do. They have to keep my beat and keep together, and I'm way down here. It's very, very, very difficult to do. I've chosen some songs that I love, like Blowing in the Wind and If I Had a Hammer, which are wonderful and just stirring and bring up a lot of wonderful, wonderful feelings, and I've had a lot of lessons in our conversations with them. But I hope you'll be just taking in the pleasure of them being able to do that. The beginning of our program is just packed with things like that. And there is some hustling up and down with instruments and things. So I hope you'll be patient with that. The end of our program will be a lot of soundtracks and choreography and wonderful things like that. Your children are amazing. We are packed tonight, and so we're not gonna spend a lot of time talking. I will tell you about this red yarn right here. The original Star Spangled Banner you're gonna hear about tonight was amazing. And you're gonna hear a little bit about the women who stitched it with a needle and thread. But it was 42 feet long, which is longer than this red yarn. Some of my students, we tried and tried and tried to make it 42 feet. It's not quite 42 feet long. But it's a great visual for us tonight, what that would have been like to see that amazing flag flying over Fort McHenry, to let other countries know that we are still Americans and we are free. 30 feet wide and 42 feet high. And we're proud tonight to come together, celebrate America, and celebrate the Star Spangled Banner. We are honored to have some of our students who are scouts and former students will do the calling, represent us with a color guard tonight, and everything that that represents in respecting our flag. And we hope that you will enjoy this wonderful evening as ElkHorn celebrates America.
The people of the United States, in order to form a more perfect union, establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and ensure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity, to ordain and establish this constitution.
newborn country. 2 years later, on September 3rd, 1814, Francis Scott Key, an attorney, was being held captive on a British warship in Baltimore Harbor. He had tried to negotiate the release of a physician and friend who was being held prisoner by the British. From the hold of the ship, Francis Scott Key watched helplessly as the British Navy attacked Fort McHenry.
All through the night, as the bomb would burst in midair, that flash of light allowed him to catch a glimpse of the American flag through the darkness and smoke.
As Francis Scott Key looked out during the battle, he knew that as long as our flag was still flying, the Americans were still free.
In the morning, he was so thrilled to see the symbol of our country raised high above the fort. He was inspired to write a poem about it.
The poem he wrote was later set to the tune of another song and eventually became America's national anthem, the Star-Spangled Banner.
So here we are, 205 years later, gathering together to celebrate our wonderful country, America.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise and join us for the Pledge of Allegiance and the Star-Spangled Banner, the national anthem of the United States of America.
Color guard attention. Color guard advance. Color guard, place the colors. Color guard dismissed.
Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
My country 'tis of thee. So it was familiar to most people.
Let music swell the breeze and ring from all the trees, sweet freedom song.
Thank you.
1940, Woody Guthrie wrote, "This land is your land," to emphasize that everyone belonged here, and America belonged to everyone.
Salute them now, 50 nifty United. and flew under the same grand old flag.
And in 1906, when George M. Cohan wrote, "Your Grand Old Flag" for a Broadway show, it was an instant hit. They loved to sing it back then, and we still love to sing it. And we still do love to sing it, 113 years later.
We will honor any shame.
we want that flag to represent all Americans. But we want that flag to represent all of us, for Americans come in all shapes and sizes.
We are young, we are old, we are wealthy, or we are not.
We have dark skin, we have light skin. We are teachers, students, soldiers, citizens, friends, neighbors, and family.
We have many who have looked before us with a vision of what our country could be.
And many have tried to use songs to help people think about America making changes.
In the middle of controversy over the Vietnam War, Bob Dylan wrote the song, Blowing in the Wind, to ask really deep questions about peace and war and freedom.
In a list of the 500 greatest songs of all time, Blowing in the Wind ranks number 14.
If I had a hammer.
which became a theme song of the American Civil Rights Movement.
She knew she had justice on her side.
For
in order to fulfill their visions. Strong people have to step up and do courageous things in difficult times.
Edmund Burke wrote, "All that is necessary for evil to triumph is that good men do nothing."
Ambrose Redmond wrote, "Courage is not the absence of fear, but rather the judgment that something else is more important than that fear."
And what a benefit to us. We live in a better country because courageous heroes among us stepped through their fear and did the right thing when it mattered.
I am grateful to live in a country with all of... I am grateful to be able to speak out when something is not right.
People come from every continent on the earth and want to live here and be free in America.
I'm grateful to have the right to participate in government and have opinions.
I am grateful we have the right to practice our religion.
MJ Ryan said, "Gratitude is like a flashlight. Shining on what's good, when you turn it on, it makes you feel happier."
Hey, I am grateful to have food for dinner
and for my family and friends.
I am truly grateful to be American.
Thank you.
my friend's dad lost his job, and they may have to sell their house.
Really? My mom says we have to cut back because stuff is getting too expensive.
I know, but Americans have been through tough times before, and we always pull through.
The Great Depression was an awful time in America, and it went on for more than 10 years.
The Civil War was one of the worst times for America. But Abraham Lincoln wrote in the Gettysburg Address, 1863, "This nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom. This government, of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth."
Even though our country is far from perfect, being an American citizen is something to be grateful for.
John F. Kennedy said, "My fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country."
I guess we can help our country by hanging in there, doing the right thing, and working to be upstanding citizens.
Or live in the same kind of
here in America. We believe strongly in that pursuit of happiness.
Do you know that people who stop and practice being thankful every day, no matter what is going on in their lives, are happier people?
I am thankful that I can walk and see.
I am thankful that I can sing. How about being thankful to live in a country with all of this freedom?
My country, 'tis a sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims' pride. From every mountainside, let freedom ring.
Well, we are all grateful to be here tonight and sing these great songs to encourage you.
We are thankful for ElkHorn School, our teachers, and staff, and especially for Mrs. White, who cares for us.
We are thankful to be just who we are and where we are tonight.
And we are especially thankful our flag stands here in freedom.
And that you can be here to show and celebrate America with us.
So, as we leave you this evening, let's all be a little more thankful for our homes and families and the people around us, and especially thankful for the USA.
You know, as I'm listening to the show, and I have to say, we are so thankful for
love Mrs. Farrell and her incredible talent, how she brings the talent out in her children. They sound like professional children's choir, don't they? So we have to give a big round of applause, Mrs. Farrell. Thank you. It shows her passion for what she does and how much she loves working with the children. So, you know, and as I was listening to this, I thought, can you imagine if our forefathers, when they were writing these songs, could be sitting here right now and looking at our diverse group, watching how they care for each other. I know you saw the love they're giving one of our little ones who's not feeling great today. That's our group. Can you imagine how they'd be saying, yes, it worked. It's so exciting. And if all of our children in the country had this civics lesson, where we would be 10 years from now, 20 years from now. So thank you for giving this opportunity to our children. Thank you for joining us tonight.